Hello and welcome back. And this week I'm going to build on the stakeholder or public's analysis tool that I gave you last week to think about how we can plan a pathway to impact that will work time efficiently for the resource and the skills that we have at our disposal. Whether you are a PhD student with very limited resource, or whether you've got a multi-million pound dollar, whatever, research project, then you need a plan, and with a plan you can make the most of what limited or massive resource you have to achieve inspiring impacts, and to do so in ways which are not going to lead to dead ends that you can, if you need to, evaluate later and demonstrate that you did actually achieve impact, and that are time efficient. So head over to the resources page on my website if you want to download a template. This is what it looks like. You can see there's a worked example in this as well when you download it. This is a logic model, so it's very logical, very simple to get your head around. And it starts with an impact goal. This is actually the bit that I find hardest, what most researchers I know struggle most with. So if that's a problem for you, then back up a moment, go back to last week's video and work out who are those people who have an interest in your work. Depending on how that worked for you, you may have answered the question, who of these interested people do I think will benefit most? And you may have described that benefit. For me, a simple definition of impact is simply benefit. If I've got a benefit, then that's an impact. So I take the benefit from my stakeholder or public's analysis and I turn that into a prototype impact goal. If I haven't got that, then I will have the answer to the question, who is interested in my research? What I then need to do is to convert interest into benefit. So I'm asking, well, why are you so interested in my research? And if I don't know, I'm going and asking someone like them, so why do you keep coming to my public lectures? What's going on? Why do you enjoy this? What do you benefit from this? Tell me more. So you've got a benefit, that's your impact. You've got a vague impact goal, which is going to start us off. If you've backed up and done that stakeholder public's analysis, then the next two columns write themselves. I want to know who are these target stakeholders or publics. What are the reasons why I think they're going to be interested in my research? And it's potentially quite narrow bits, and for each group it's going to be a different thing. It's not just the whole project. I'm asking, are there specific things that are more likely to be relevant to this group compared to the next group? From there, I ask what kind of activities I can do. So potentially very different activities for different groups. This is not a one size fits all. And this is one of the key reasons this is so valuable. So I may do something very different for civil servants, for example, compared to politicians at higher levels. For one team within a company versus another team, for example. So I've got some specific activities. They're tailored to the interests and needs, limitations, characteristics of those different groups. I'm now asking myself for some indicators of successful engagement and indicators of impact. So I've got these activities. Are they working? How will I know if they're working or not? So I can get some regular feedback on that progress and understand if I'm doing something wrong, if I need to enhance my practice. Great. The same with indicators of impact. I'm going to ask if there are particular milestones I would expect to see along the way, and what impact would look like. What would I expect to see? What might I be able to count? What would people say if this had changed their lives? Let's give some colour, some flavour, some structure to what this might actually look like and what might I actually be able to evaluate. And at this point, I need to ask some fairly searching questions. So I've put here and means of measurement, whether that's qualitative or quantitative evidence you're collecting here. Actually, what am I going to collect? Have I got time to do that? If not, then do I need to put in some resource, draw on some favours, talk to some other PhD students within my cohort, have a budget line in my project, task a postdoc with this? But I know ahead of time that if I want to be able to prove this, I'm going to have to invest a bit of time, energy, perhaps resource in making this happen. And I know exactly what I've got to collect if I want to be able to prove any claim at a later date. Great, I'm prepared. Now, if you head over to my website, you can also see my impact tracking template, which is basically this table, but I've just expanded it out to add in some traffic lights. And you can again see a worked example of that if you download that template. So you can then, using that template with this template, now in quarterly meetings, in progression meetings with your supervisors, come back and have a look at this and see, is this working? And if you've got a red on some of these activities or impacts consistently, meeting after meeting, well, hey, maybe I need a plan B. Great, so we're getting some feedback. Now, at this point, I've added so much structure, color, flavor to this in terms of what this would actually look like and what I might be able to evaluate. I can go back to my impact goal now. And what might have looked like a fairly vague benefit now, I can turn into a SMART objective. So it's specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, time-bound. And this is now much more competitive if I want to put this into a research bid pre-award. Great. Now, while I'm thinking about the great stuff, of course, there's a whole lot of risks and assumptions that reveal themselves to me. Well, okay, actually, this is what might go wrong. This might be some of the unintended negative consequences. What could I do to mitigate them? And great, as I'm building this into a research proposal, again, way more competitive because, yeah, I've thought about this. This is way more credible. But in terms of what I'm actually doing, I'm hopefully predicting some of the things that go wrong before they happen and making a plan, and I'm much more likely to actually achieve good stuff rather than bad stuff. And then finally, who's responsible for what and when? Do I need extra resources? I make this very concrete. I make a plan. Now, to conclude, for me, I'm trying in this series of videos to give you things that you can do really quickly and easily. So zooming out from this, I've got now a whole series of different goals, lots of different pathways that I could pursue. And now I get to choose, which of these do I want to pursue? And for me, the first thing I do is I ask, well, which of them do I care about? Which ones am I passionate about? Okay, so these goals, that's where I'm zooming in. And now of all these different pathways, which of these look actually achievable with the time and resources I've got? With my skills, and which of these, if it's important to me, could I actually evaluate and prove? And whatever are the most important criteria, I then use to say, right, these are the pathways I'm going to prioritize, the ones I can do in time with this amount of resource, and I do things that work and that are time efficient. I've got a plan, I follow that plan, I monitor my progress, and I get impacts. Brilliant. We'll be right back.